ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand and welcome our new Witten family men's head basketball coach, Dennis Gates, and university leadership. You may be seated. M-I-Z. Good morning. I'm Mike Kelly, the voice of the Missouri Tigers, and it is with great honor that I stand before you today on this exciting day. As you know, earlier this morning, the Board of Curators officially approved Dennis Gates as the 20th head coach in Missouri basketball history. Today, we will get a chance to not only meet Coach Gates and his family, but also hear about his vision for the Mizzou basketball program. First, though, we have several members of the university leadership that want to share a few words with you. Our first speaker represents the University of Missouri Board of Curators. Will you please welcome Curator Jeff Lehman, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mike, and thank you all for joining us today. It's a great day to be a Tiger. Congratulations to our AD, Desiree Reed Francois. She's a fantastic leader, and she just hired one of the best young coaches in the nation. Coach Gates is a tremendous talent evaluator, a relentless recruiter, a phenomenal teacher, and a winner. The future of Missouri basketball is bright. On behalf of the Board of Curators, welcome to Mizzou, Coach Gates. M-I-Z.
When we talk about bold and transformative leaders, our next speaker is just that. Please welcome the president of the University of Missouri System, Dr. Moon Choi.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here. And let's do that one more time. M-I-Z. Well, to be in this building with the tradition that we've had in Mizzou basketball, I am just so pleased to be here. When we hired our athletics director, Desiree Reed Francois, she said that excellence must be the expectation. And I believe that. That has to permeate throughout the entire university. And quickly, she is developing that results-based championship culture right here at the University of Missouri. And that's why I'm so excited to welcome our new coach. Our new coach that is a proven winner. He's going to bring an exciting brand of basketball to Missouri. He is a relentless recruiter, and he's also a character builder, and that's critically important for our university. But he's also impressed us with his focus on achieving excellence, and that's going to begin by winning the hearts and minds of our player athletes, the fans in Missouri, winning games, winning the SEC, and winning championships. And that's gonna start today because of the commitment that we have and the support for this coach. Welcome. Now, as many of you know, the board, the president, and all of the leaders, including our AD, we believe in the model of the state. It's a show-me state. We have very high hopes, but we know that you're going to show all of us and the nation that Mizzou basketball is back and is going to be in charge. So welcome, and let's get to work. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you. Good job. Thank you. Her vision of a championship culture is on display today with our new men's basketball coach. Please welcome Mizzou's 21st Director of Athletics, Desiree Reed Francois.
Thank you, Mike. President Choi, Curator Lehman, it's a great day for Mizzou athletics. I wanted to start with a few thank yous. It takes a great deal of support from a number of people, and we're lucky to have incredible alignment with our partners on campus. So, to our board of curators, thank you for your care, thank you for your support, thank you for your faith. To President Choi, for his tireless support, his insight, his wisdom, and his energy, thank you, sir. To our student athletes, our coaches, and our Mizzou fan base, thank you for your patience, thank you for your faith, and I'm just so excited, so thank you. And to our staff, Greg, Brad, saw Brad back there, Coach Brad, Ryan, Morgan, Rachel, Colleen, Sarah, Will number two, Will 2.0, Tony, Sandy, thank you all so much for your behind the scenes work. You don't get the thanks that you deserve, but know how much I appreciate you. This was a comprehensive and an efficient national search. We sought a leader with character, with competence, and the temperament to lead young men. We sought a tireless recruiter. We sought an innovative tactician, a program builder, a connector, who would develop a competitive and an engaging basketball program. During this process, I had the pleasure of speaking with an impressive group of coaches, and it became very clear to me that Dennis Gates was everything we were looking for in the next leader of our basketball program. I watched him as an assistant at Florida State when I was in the ACC, and later as a two-time conference coach of the year who completely transformed a program at Cleveland State. It became apparent why Coach Gates was so sought after. He has distinguished himself with his energy, his intellect, his ability to connect, his competitive drive, his humility, and his experience at the highest levels of basketball. He plays an exciting brand of basketball. It's a fast offense, it's a tough defense, and it's going to capture the attention and the heart of our fan base and our recruits. He's innovative and he is relentless. In Dennis Gates, we found a passionate, prepared, and values-based leader. He has and will continue to recruit the best and the brightest. He will develop their talents, and he is going to connect and engage with people in our community. Missouri fans know great basketball. You deserve great basketball. And he is smart, he is hungry, and he is focused on winning. He is an exceptional teacher of the game, and I am just very excited. And you know, we are pleased to welcome Coach Gates and Jocelyn Gates. Jocelyn Gates, his wife, is a respected leader in our industry. And when you know Jocelyn, you're going to know that Coach Gates can recruit. We are also very excited to welcome Avery, his daughter, Duke, and Denver to the Tiger family. It is my privilege now to introduce you to the University of Missouri Witten family men's basketball head coach, Dennis Gates.
That wasn't for me, was it? How you guys doing? How are you guys doing? How are you guys doing? That's outstanding. Well, I want to first say thank you. Thank you to the Board of Curators. I really mean that. Thank you, guys. Thank you, President Moon Choi. Thank you, our Director of Athletics, Desiree Reed Francois. Each conversation that I had in this process revealed to me what you guys already know, how aligned we are as an institution, but also how special this place really is. Those conversations is why I'm standing here today. To Cleveland State University, thanks to President Harlan Sands, thanks to Athletic Director Scott Garrett, thanks to the young men who gave me and that institution their very best every day, and the many others in that department, at that institution, who rolled their sleeves up and helped us accomplish what we've accomplished. I would not be here today without the many educators and coaches who poured into my life at a young age in Chicago, Illinois. It was not easy. It wasn't easy. But if you're a coach and an educator, those are lifelong relationships, lifelong friendships, and lifelong dreams that you pour into the lives of young people. I thank my mentors, Leonard Hamilton, George Ravelin, Ben Braun, unbelievable people, unbelievable coaches, unbelievable mentors. I thank them. You know what, 20 years ago, I remember telling George Ravelin and Leonard Hamilton, Coach, I want to be just like you. Just like you. 20 years later, they continue to answer my calls. So I guess I did and have done a great job, but I appreciate those guys. And it became their dream. It became those guys' dream to see my dream come true. And as young people, we have to continue to share our dreams in full transparency, because you are gonna be heard. You are gonna be listened to. But more importantly, the right person will listen. And that's what we all have to continue to do, listen to our young people. I thank my family, my parents, my siblings, my wife's Jocelyn, thank you. Thank you for being so amazing. Desiree already said how amazing you were. She's telling the truth. Thank you for being amazing. You're a great wife, a great mom, a great friend. Thank you. And coaching requires, guys, successful coaching requires you to be absent from your home. Absent from your home. A great educator, a great coach, you're absent from your home. There are sacrifices. It requires your children to make space underneath that umbrella and move over for some student athletes. So they may not fully understand it now, but I have to go on the record and thank my children for doing that. I love you guys. Guys, like so many people, basketball and whatever other sports, whatever other hobbies, whether it's in music, we've used things as a compass to help us navigate. Basketball was that for me. I remember years ago during my in-home recruiting visits, I asked each coach a question. I said, do you have, now I'm 18, 17 years old, I said, do you have rules and regulations against freshmen becoming captains? Yeah, I asked that question. And there was one coach who sat at the edge of his seat toward me. The remainder pushed back and said, what is this kid talking about? What is he talking about? In that moment, I was asking exactly what my coaches and educators said to me when I tried to throw it all away. I tried. But they held up the mirror. They allowed me to see the best version of myself. They whispered in my ear, or even yelled at the high pitch of their voice and said, you're a leader. Or, you are a leader. And I heard them. I literally heard them. And I thank them. So I thank Ben Braun, who I played for, who sat at the edge of his seat and said, I want you to be a leader for me. That's why I decided on Cal Berkeley. That's why I made that jump. I believed in him because he believed in me. Recruiting process wasn't easy, and I remember Norm Stewart recruiting me out of Chicago, Whitney Young. We were the number one high school team in the country. He recruited me. At that point, the seed of how special Missouri was at that time was planted. It was nurtured. Although I decided elsewhere, things come full circle. I listened. And those conversations that I had with Norm Stewart was definitely brought back up in my spirit, in my heart, when I spoke with our leadership. My dream, and I'll share with you because you guys are listening, my dream is to become a national champion. My dream is to become a Hall of Fame coach. Mizzou has everything in place for me to accomplish those goals, those dreams, those aspirations. So just like those coaches and educators whispered to me, I'm gonna whisper to you. I need all of you to join hands and help build something special. I need you. We have a great institution in a great state, from Kansas City to St. Louis, from north all the way down to the Boot Hill. An unbelievable state. We have great tradition here. I spoke of Norm Stewart, but the many players that believe that this place was special as well, and the many students, the student body that believes this place is very special. There's a lot of coaches and educators in this state, grassroots, that are preparing young people to impact this institution. We have a great high school association. We have great alignment, like I said, starting with our curators all the way down to our student body, as well as the employees that work here behind the scenes. We have a special fan base. We have it. We have what it takes, guys. I can't make a promise, but I will guarantee you this. You will see a core set of values in our players, from friendship, love, accountability, trust, discipline, unselfishness, enthusiasm, and toughness. Those eight core values will lead us into our championship ways, and we're going to win championships in the classroom, on the court, in our community. We're going to win them. To our current team, you may not have chosen me, but I choose you. I choose you. To our former players, you may not have chosen me, but I choose you. To our fan base, to our student body, you may not have chosen me, but I choose you. I ask you today to do the same thing I have done. Do the same thing that our administration has done. And let's do it together. One day, like I said, we will cut down nets, hold up trophies. We will raise banners. I one day will sit in a green room with a first round draft pick. You two will sit on the TV stand and watch or listen to that person get drafted. How do we do that? We do it together. We do it the Mizzou way. To our student body, our fans, our alumni, our former players, along with everyone who loves Mizzou, everyone who have created unbelievable memories at this great institution, I invite you, wherever you are, I invite you to create some new ones. Come create some new ones with all of us. Come support these young men. Come support the future. Come support us, and you too will cut some of that net down. You too will raise that banner. You too will raise that trophy. M-I-Z. Yeah. Thank you, and God bless you.
We're now going to transition into the press conference part of the program. We have two wireless microphones that will be able to assist you in terms of asking your question. I ask that as you raise your hand that when you take the microphone, please give your name and affiliation so Coach Gates can start putting some names and faces together. So with that, let's begin. If you have a question, a member of the media, please raise your hand and we will get a microphone to you immediately. Let's go right over here to my right. Molly, please introduce yourself, please.
Hey, Coach. Natalie Jones, ABC 17 News here in Columbia. Obviously, you know, you say you remember Norm Stewart recruiting you out of high school. What else do you kind of remember about the history of Mizzou and what kind of you read up on recently? You know, obviously a rich historic program Mizzou is.
Well, thanks for the question. The special things that stand out is a unbelievable institution from an academic standpoint, but also being a flagship Power Five institution in the state. It's only us, Mizzou. That means something. That means a lot. You look at the tradition of this institution as well as the tradition of our athletic department. The many sports help recruit our student athletes, not just basketball, but football, baseball, soccer, all of the sports galvanizes the opportunity that we have in store. So that's a great question. I can go on and on, but I do want to give others an opportunity to ask, but this is a special place. I left Leonard Hamilton, my mentor, to go to a special place. Cleveland State is a special place. It's hard to leave something that you have built. It's hard and difficult. The people, it's difficult. But I left a special place for a special place. And this is a special place where I'm trusting my dreams and aspirations with, as well as you guys trusting your dreams and aspirations with as well. So I appreciate it, and that's why.
Coach, directly in front of you, we're going four rows back. Your question, please.
Hi, Dennis. Anthony Christensen with the Columbia, Missouri. And I was just wondering if you've gotten the chance to talk to the current players just yet and what you said to them or what you plan to say to them if you haven't gotten the chance.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The morning was interesting. I woke up with a lot of emotions. It was like a kid on Christmas Day, right? Excited to talk to the young men in the program, excited to get here and talk to you guys. But in the team atmosphere of it, I just allowed them to see who I was as a person, as a man, as a head coach here. Is sometimes territorial or even tough to look at because I'm a coach who's coming from somewhere else, right? We're in transition. When young people go through transition, you gotta protect their hearts, right? And Desiree, you protected their hearts in that transition, and I appreciate that. They were receptive. I told them my vision, my plans, the core values that I listed to you guys today. But more importantly, I wanted them to ask me questions. I wanted those guys to be able to control the environment because too often as adults, we don't listen to young people in those traumatic stages. Trauma for anybody, we have to pay attention to. We have to listen. We have to open our hearts, open our ears. And I just wanted to listen. So I told them my background, where I'm from, and I even cracked a joke. And they all laughed. I said, you guys Googled me, didn't you? And they all, yeah, coach. So it was fun, man. It was exciting. But that's pretty much the same message that I sat here and shared. It's what they heard.
Right behind him. Go ahead.
Hey, Coach. My name is Benjamin Hockman from the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. Nice to meet you.
How you doing?
Good, good. Two quick questions. One, can you share the names of any assistant coaches that you've added to your staff, if you have already? And two, can you just describe how you hope to utilize NIL?
Yeah. So as it relates to the staff, it's going to be important, and I can't talk about individuals right now at this stage simply because I want to keep that private, for not just for myself, but for them. I don't want to put them in any compromising situations publicly or even with their fan bases or anything else, right? So I have to respect that. So sorry I can't answer. As it relates to name, image, and likeness, it has equalized the college game. It has equalized everything about our sport. But more importantly, I will tell you this. Young people can't make decisions just based off that. They have to be previewed to who we are as an institution, how we treat our current program on a game-to-game basis will be important, essential. Kids make more decisions about what they see in the stands, what they see on the sidelines, what they see in a coach, than in name, image, and likeness. So while it's important, it's very important, there's a lot of other important things that we have to continue to show them for them to make the right decision. So that's a good question. I appreciate it.
Coach, we're going to the opposite side, four rows back.
Coach Ben Arnett, KOMU 8 TV here in Columbia. As you move from mid-major to Power 5 as a head coach, what do you feel like the difference will be? And perhaps more importantly, what do you need to hold on to that's made you successful regardless of the level?
President Sands and Scott Garrett said I was a high major coach last year. No, I'm just joking. Or Cleveland State was a high major school. So to make light of it, man, my mentors have prepared me for this moment. Leonard Hamilton often moved to the side and allowed me to lead in moments that prepared me and gave me the confidence to be here. From the scouting, from the responsibilities daily, to even the interactions to our community, fan base, boosters, alumni, and administration. He allowed me to do that on his watch, and that's why I thank him. Everyone here who has had a leadership position has been thrown out there, and obviously, training wheels taken off. Leonard Hamilton allowed the training wheels to be taken off under his watch. And that success is why I'm here now. Thanks.
Okay, we're going to stay in that row. Straight ahead.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Lila Bromber with the Kansas City Star.
Nice to meet you.
How did you approach rebuilding the Cleveland State program, and how can you carry over that experience to help you here?
Oh, absolutely. That's a good question. Well, I didn't do it alone. I did not build it alone. I built it with the president, athletic director, and the entire community. The welcome arms that it takes, the smiles on the faces that it takes to receive young people, their families. They want to trust with someone. During the fleeting moments of 4 years, it's a fleeting moment with lasting and everlasting impressions. So it's not done alone. It's done when they walk in a restaurant on campus. It's done when they walk into the bookstore or walk on the quad. It's done when their family can sit with our athletic director, our president, on their visit. It's done when they go to the football game, baseball game, soccer game, softball game. It's done during those moments when they visit for 48 hours or 36 hours or 24 or a day. That's when it's done. It's done behind the scenes when they can visualize themselves walking on this campus because it's special. So for me, I can take the credit. My name may be on something, but it belongs to a lot of people. And here, it will belong to all of us. So I appreciate that question, and I'm excited to build with all of you guys.
Coach, we're going to your left over on the aisle, four rows back.
Coach Haley Lewis with the NBC station in Kansas City. I want to ask you, I mean, it sounds like you're a player's coach, which is incredible, obviously, having that relationship with the players. But at the end of the day, it does translate to wins and losses on the court. Yeah. So how do you, as quickly as you were able to, without even a full recruiting class at Cleveland State, plan to do that at Power 5 level here in Kansas City, or excuse me, here in Columbia, and bring a winning record back to Mizzou?
Yeah, I've done it at Florida State. That's a great question. The same philosophy. I did that at Florida State, and I, again, was prepared by my mentors. The first most important thing in it all is to break down the barriers between young people, their dreams, aspirations. We have to allow what they see in a distant to be right in front of them because every decision matters. We have to be able to be their psychologist, their psychiatrist. We have to be able to be their that person that they can lean on. The true judgment in me is that moment that they decide to trust their career in my hands. They play hard because they know one day they'll invite me to their wedding. I'm sitting behind their parents. They'll know one day when it's time to retire that they'll call me and say, Coach, what do you think? That trust is important. And without that trust, you cannot build anything. So that's how I plan on doing it, with trust, which is one of our core values.
Coach, we're coming back to this side, midway, row four.
Hi, Dennis. Welcome to Columbia. I'm Vi Gregorian with the Kansas City Star.
Yes.
It seems, I think I've got this right, your entire head coaching career, you've been dealing with COVID, NIL, or transfer portal stuff. And I'm just curious how your adaptability to all that might speak to your ability to create a program.
Well, hopefully that leads to my ability to in-game adjust too, right? Because that's what it's about. All of us have to adjust somehow. You have to be flexible. You got to be able to pivot. It's a unique time in college basketball, but also our world. So first and foremost, if you, your family, friends, loved ones have been impacted by COVID, my heart is with you. It's our day and age. You know, if I check anyone's pocket right now, you will not have a Blockbuster card. You wouldn't have one in your pocket. You would not have that relic. Some of us would. But it's a Netflix. Things evolved. Things are evolving right before. This is the right time for me to be here. And that's why I know I can trust my dream of being a Hall of Fame coach. I can trust my dream of winning a national championship here with Mizzou, but also Mizzou can trust me being the Witten family head men's basketball coach.
Next question, right next to that gentleman.
Hey, Dennis, welcome to Columbia. Dave Matter with the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, and welcome
Appreciate
Jocelyn
it.
And your family, too.
Thanks, Seth.
The folks sitting to your right.
Yes.
How did they express to you what the expectations for this program are? This is a year ago, this team was in an NCAA tournament and nationally ranked. So what was expressed to you, what they expect you to deliver?
Did you just hear president? It's no different than what was mentioned. Guys, I'm going to be measured. You know, I know the business and profession I'm in. I realize that. I am not running from it. I'm here to tussle with you. I'm here to fight against our opponents. Not just the SEC, but in the country. I understand that. I understand the expectation because my success can open doors for other people. I understand that. So the words is not just national championship. It's not just a SEC championship. It's also to watch our kids walk across the stage. That's what it's also about. So a win, it may not be visible on ESPN and a sports ticker, but wins come in different ways, opportunities that we give. I want to see kids graduate, walk across the stage. That's also a win. I want to see our institution be nationally recognized as an athletic department, sport among sport. I'm here because I know it's possible. It's the Sears Cup, right? Director's Cup. I want the Director's Cup here. And I know I have a piece in delivering that. The same with our student body. I want our campus to continue to grow. I want opportunities to be seen. Those are championships. They're just not labeled that all the time, but to someone it is. Someone it is. So I appreciate that question. That's a great question.
We have time for two more. We're going to take one in that same row to the right, please.
Coach, welcome to Columbia. Congratulations on the new job.
Thank you.
I'm Mark Slavitt with KRCG, the local CBS station here in Columbia. My question for you is, are you going to concentrate your recruitment in Missouri, or are you going to equally distribute that across the country?
Absolutely. That's a great question. First of all, I have to continue to study, and I have studied. What has allowed this institution to be special? Well, we've had kids from Long Beach, California. We've had kids from Detroit. We've had kids from Florida. We had kids internationally. We had kids from Chicago. But we also had kids home. That will be important. And in all of that success, we had fans driving from all over the place to fill the arena. We have to get back to that. We have to get back to that. Because once we continue to do that on a daily basis, it will then allow our guys an opportunity to do it, obviously, over several seasons, not just one season. So for me, we have to have our recruiting base be international, not even just national, because there are young men at every corner of this country and the world that can help this program, help us play the style, the exciting style, where fast-paced offense meets fast-paced pressure defense. There's a lot of student athletes that can help in that.
Coach,
but we have to put a fence around our state.
I apologize. We're coming over to the left-hand side for our final question.
Yeah, Coach Gabe DeArmond with PowerMizzou.com and Rivals.com.
Absolutely.
You've talked a lot about Coach Hamilton. Two-part question. How did you know when the time was to further your career that you needed to leave Coach Hamilton? And what have you learned in those 3 years where you're not just taking Leonard's program and moving it somewhere
Absolutely.
Else in the country?
That's a great question, several-part question. So as it relates to the second part, through the years, and I want you to think about my home visit as a young kid with Ben Braun, I started building my program at the age of 18. And every year, every season, I flipped it and pivoted and seen what I need to change, literally, in notebooks, literally, page by page. I've done that every step of the way. So I've always put my unique spin on what we do. What I've learned from Leonard Hamilton is very important. It's a very important piece. He taught me how to do it and gave me the space. No different than the space my family gives me to be successful and absent from my home. He gave me the space, the time, the effort to show me and look in the mirror that I could be successful. He allowed me to make some crucial decisions. That is important. The first part of your question, I'll admit it, I forgot by now. Yes. So sometimes the best opportunities are in our lives are presented at times where you're like, this ain't the right time. We put together a national championship team. It was July 30th. School starts in 2 weeks. Do I help Leonard Hamilton win a national championship? This is the best team he has ever had in his head coaching career. Or do I take Cleveland State? Well, every friend of mine in this business said, I'm committing career suicide by choosing Cleveland State. There were three guys in the program, 2 weeks. There was no staff. I had to do all this in 2 weeks. That same team that we put together, they won championships. They cut down nets, held up trophies, and they raised banners. So for me, the time was right because I knew the sacrifice was greater. It was greater. And when you step out like that, there is no choice but to succeed.
Mizzou fans, give it up for our Witten family. Men's basketball coach, Dennis Gates.